Limo drivers of Reddit, what's the craziest crap that's gone down in your limo? My mom was a driver for about 12 years. She just said a dead body. Apparently a bachelor party had booked the limo and had the partition up. They were doing drugs and apparently the guy OD'd and they just left him there. A friend owns a limo company. A few weeks ago someone took a dump in the ice box in one of his limos. The best part was that someone from the party called a few days later and was like, "We left something in the limo." Yes, yes you did. And I hope there's a crazy expensive cleaning fee for dealing with stuff like that. I drove for a drunk bus company years ago in a college town that had a few limos for weddings and stuff. Some Saturday night I drove for a couple that had rented the limo for an anniversary date night or something. I picked them up at their place to drive then into the city for their dinner. They were standard fare. Fat. Middle-aged. Quiet. The only thing out of the ordinary is the guy is already tipping me really well. And they hadn't even eaten yet. Anyways, they eat for a few hours and when I come pick them up, he folds another hundo into my palm and asks me if I can close the privacy divider. Sure I figure, they want to do some cute kissy stuff and whisper sweet nothings. Up goes the divider. We weren't 3 minutes from the restaurant when I got super freaked out because it felt like the limo was having serious engine problems. As I'm sure you can guess. And as I realized once the jerking went from forward to back to side, no engine problems. That guy was just railing the crap out of his wife. Like, hard. I was having trouble staying in the lane on the interstate home. And yes, they fricked the entire 30-minute drive back. Now, the company had a strict no fricking policy for riders, but there was something about the intensity of the fricking in the back of that limo that scared me. No way was I going to get in the way of that. We finally arrived back at their place and as they crawled out, both visibly coated in sweat, or urine, who knows, that poor fat woman muttered something about the AC not working while the husband gave me another $200 and winked. And that was it. Luckily, and who the frick knows why, but it was company policy to clean the back out when you start your shift, and not at the end. Sorry other guy colon. You got tipped $400, who cares? My mother used to work for a company that built limos and party buses and the owner also ran a rental service. They had one bus that was aptly named the stripper bus. The thing had poles, a see-through shower, satin and velvet, everything. The bus was rented out in Detroit one time and it came back in terrible condition. So bad that it had to come into the shop to have a lot of work done. When my mom asked what happened, the owner simply replied, 15 cops and 30 H. My mom asked him what he was going to do about it and he kind of chuckled and said, "Who the frick am I supposed to call? The cops?" I drive for Uber and I've given a ride to a man who was tripping balls on magic mushrooms. He kept telling me and the other, much more coherent, passenger about how the road is the universe and each dashed line in the lane markings is a human lifetime. In retrospect, that ain't half bad as far as analogies go. I was in Times Square right after a show let out on a Saturday night. Needless to say, a lot of people around to witness a limo drive by with a 20-something woman hanging her head out the window vomiting on her long hair and all over the side of the limo. Proud night. I know some girls who had a limo for prom or something and ended up taking all of their tops off and pretending to flash the other cars for fun, not realizing that all the lights were on in the limo and everyone could see right in. My limo driver for prom made an illegal U-turn on a major road and caused a 6-car pileup. He was making the turn to pick us up. We had no idea until we were sitting at the light waiting to leave and a lady came banging on the window that she was calling the police. Once we heard him speak, it was clear he was intoxicated. We immediately got out of the limo and I sat on a bench in front of a Bank of America for over an hour waiting for our parents. We forfeited our time and never did get our money back. I drove for a town car company for a few years. I picked up a guy that was a regular. He always had a ton of cash. My boss had me call him to pick him up. At the end of the night he wanted a ride into downtown. Bars here close at 2 AM. So it was weird he wanted to go to a bar at 2:30 in the morning. My boss said if he's paying, take him and drop him. Then drive away. As we're making the half hour trek from the suburbs. He's going on and on about the drugs he sells, the houses he keeps them at. He pulls out a crap ton of cash, asks me if I've ever seen 10,000 in cash before, proceeds to slap it across my face and laughs. He's wasted and babbling about his drug operation and illegal gambling ring. I bring him to the bar, ask for the fare money, and he tells me he'll double it if I wait here for him real quick. He runs into the bar. My boss tells me to wait for the money. He comes back out right about the time another car pulls up and starts eyeing me up. Being a lone female in this neighborhood isn't the easiest. He tells me to come in quick. So I step inside the bar. Inside there are a ton of people getting high, snorting coke, and drinking way after this bar should be closed. I get stopped by some burly security guards. My passenger tells them I'm his personal driver, so they leave me alone. He goes into the bathroom, comes out with an 8 ball of coke, then tells me it's time to go. We go back to the car, and I'm ready to drop him off back in the suburbs. As I'm driving, he cuts 4 lines on the clipboard I do my paperwork on. He's telling me about the cops he's paid off. As he's telling me this, an officer pulls up next to us. He does a line, stares the officer down, they nod their heads at each other and the cop drives away. He does 2 more lines, then gets super paranoid. He's rambling about how I must be a cop, I'm a big girl, not cop material at all, and tells me to prove I'm not by snorting a line. I refuse, nicely of course. I'm nervous by this point. I get onto the highway and he's freaking out harder. He pulls out a gun, places it to my head and tells me to snort the line or he is going to shoot me. I get the car up to 95 miles an hour and inform him that if he shoots me, we'll crash and he'll die too. He sat there for a moment, smiles and says I like you, you can live. He does the line and I drop him off at his place. He drops a grand on the seat and tells me to keep my freaking mouth shut. That was the scariest thing I've ever been through. TLDR. Drug dealer took me on a deal, threatened my life, then paid me a crap ton. Way to not keep your freaking mouth shut. I'm not a limo driver, but the best day of my life was when I was 9 and my friend used to carpool us. However, her father was a limo driver and on the last day of school he picked us up in the limo. Tens of kids were piled up at the window trying to look into it and me and my friend just strolled in and got into the limo. Then we watched Finding Nemo on the way home. My friend was a town car driver, those really nice private cars, and one night he picked up a group of drunk people, 2 women and 2 men. One of the women sits up front with him and starts slurring flirts at him. He is laughing and having a good time, but is paying attention to the road and doesn't see her grab the intercom thing for the radio, the thing used to contact dispatch. By the time she realizes what she has in her hand, she has already pressed the button and is saying to all of the other drivers and dispatch, "Mr. Driver, I wanna lick your balls." Then she puts it down and doesn't stop laughing the rest of the ride. I would have never believed him if I hadn't done a ride along and talked to the other drivers that were working the night that happened. That's just one of the many stories, but it's my favorite. When my parents started dating, my dad was a limo driver for musicians who played in major concerts in Philadelphia. I can't remember all of the stories, but I believe he said the Moody Blues were drunk buttholes who threw things at their fans outside the limo. Another story is on my parents' second date, which was going to happen after he drove U2 to their concert. My dad picked my mom up, then picked up U2 from the airport, and they proceeded to be complete jerks to my mom. They got dropped off for their concert and my parents went to dinner. Hey guys, I know nobody will see this, but, our limo club. I actually made an entire sub for this a while back, so if you guys want to share more stories, feel free to do so over there as well. Cheers. You just broke the first rule of your own subreddit. Limo rider here. This fancy restaurant I had no business being at had a limo available to any guests, so I went for it and booked the dude. Dinner ends, I'm 6 plus Jameson's in, and this guy comes up to me and says, "I'm your driver, but here's the thing, Senator blah 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 is in town and I have to. You want to sit in front?" "Yeah, actually, that would be cool. Let's stop at Fry's for beers." "Cool," and so I sat in the front, dropped the guy off, stumbled into Fry's and grabbed a rack of beer for the 7-minute drive home. Limo driver in Vegas here. I have so many good stories. A few years ago, a famous Oscar-winning actor asked me for blow. This past New Year's I had some pretty famous party girl jumped in my limo with her entourage. They asked to go cruising around and come back to the hotel. They jump in and roll up the partition. After driving around for about 45 minutes, they ask me to take them back. I pull back into the hotel, they jump out and give me $500 on an $80 ride and apologize for the mess. The inside was trashed. I called it a night right after that. When I start cleaning out the car, I look in between the seats and find a small bag filled with coke. I have so many good stories. Well, that rules out DiCaprio. My dad told me this one a bit ago. He was in Monaco for some convention thing of my granddad's when he was about 15, and they were staying at some little inexpensive pensioner bed and breakfast in Antibes with lots of funky people, including the chauffeur for the Prince of Oman. The British chauffeur, John, turned out to be quite funny, and my dad, aunt, and grandparents talked to him a few times. One day, my dad, aunt, and grandparents were planning to go to the Monte Carlo casino in their rental car for something to do. Having talked with them earlier, John overheard them and offered my dad and aunt a ride in his Bentley since he had to pick up the ambassador around there anyway. So he drove them for almost an hour and the three of them talked in the front seat like friends. But right before they arrived, he pulled over and had them move to the back. They pulled up to the casino and two teenagers in their shorts, flip-flops and Ray-Bans come out, looking as important as the prince the Bentley was originally for. I was 14 or 15 and too dumb to realize that my girlfriend's sister's boyfriend was her pimp. I was also too dumb to realize that the limo he was removing the decals from was stolen. I rode in that limo. My dad used to be a limo driver, owner of a limo service company, and this is go-to story. Not really crazy, but is funny. He was on his way to pick up group of women to take them to the coast for a cruise. Now the leader of the group wasn't with the group and had to be picked up at her place while everyone else was at another house. When my dad picked up the first lady, she had already started the party. She was completely drunk. My dad ushered her to the limo and introduced himself as so. Hello, my name is Farhad. It's an Iranian name and some people struggle with it, so if you want you can call me Frank. Now they've arrived to where everybody else is. As all the other ladies climb into the limo, my dad, being the gentleman that he is, starts introducing himself. Hello, my nah. He gets completely cut off by the drunk lady by saying this guy is named it, 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 named. This was so mildly funny. In this case, I was a passenger. I felt terrible for our limo driver. It was prom night 3 years ago. We took a limo from prom to a beach an hour and some change away. The kid whose dad rented the limo filled it with champagne, wine and other drinks, which we finished at least 4 bottles of alcohol on the way over there. We were pretty tipsy, and my girlfriend and I were in the very back, whereas my best friend and her boyfriend were in the side seat. My girlfriend and I are talking, even making out a little, and next thing you know, we are watching my best friend ride some dong. Oh, Christ, dude. So they are going at it and she starts screaming, and the divider window rolls down, and I see our female limo driver's eyes widen to the size of golf balls, and they still kept going. Me and GF are hiding our faces and the divider rolls up, and they finish. Phew, glad that's over. Nope. Best friend's boyfriend rolls the divider down, asks if we can stop. I roll my eyes but say nothing, and we stop. Me, GF and limo driver all get out for a smoke and the other two go inside the gas station. We start having a convo. You girls alright with that stuff? Yeah, it's prom night. We get it. Suddenly, our friends are running to us. The limo driver doesn't act crap. Just drops a cig and run. We jump in the limo, and next thing I know, we see this dude holding his pants up and screaming at us as we drive off. We all tipped her $150 each. Apparently the friends started doing it in one of the aisles while an employee was up front and manager was in the RR. Never again. Some woman got in carrying a life-sized blow-up doll of Eminem. No one except the lady and Eminem was in the entire limo. So I was silent as I witnessed her doing some crazy sexual crap to the inflatable. It was awkward as frick. Not a limo driver, but I drive a bus for a college. Every Saturday an unknown guy masturbates in the same spot in the back of the bus. I do this, and I'm also from Indiana and I go to college. I drive limo in MPLS. I was working overnight and got a call at around 4 a.m. from a nice hotel downtown, saying there was a woman that needed a ride to the airport. When I got there, I waited like 5 minutes or so, and then this lady came walking out in a tight mini dress, curves for days, breasts for weeks. I was like, ok, this is cool. So she gets in the backseat of my car and we start driving off. She has a thick Latin accent, so I asked her where she was from and she says Miami. I could tell she was a stripper or an escort. Anyways, we were just bullshitting when she asks what nationality I am. And I told her that my family is from France. Then she says, oh, I heard French boys don't get circumcised, and I told her that I was. LOL, sorry for the TMI, but that's how it started. So then she told me to prove it, and asked if she could take it out. Normally driving a limo downtown, I get a lot of women making advances on me, some drunk and some not, but I have never acted on it before. But this lady was just too hot and she was pushing the issue pretty hard, so I gave in. She basically gave me a hand LOL all the way to the airport, and then paid me $55 all in $1 bills LOL. Stripper status confirmed. So I guess I am a gigolo now. True story, I was a limo driver in New York City for a number of years. This was during the 90s. One year, during the holidays, I got a call for a pickup at a hotel. I was tasked with being the chaperone for a young kid from Chicago. He was alone, but I didn't care. He had his father's credit card, so I knew he was good for the fare. Anyways, I took him to a toy shop and a trip around NYC. The kid had a strange obsession with eating an entire cheese pizza. After the trip was over, I returned him back to the Plaza Hotel, New York's finest hotel experience. Here's an upvote, and keep the change, you filthy animal. My buddy was a limo driver. Gucci Mane threw him and his partner an 8 ball of coke and told him to enjoy and cruise around Little Rock. They ended up cruising about 20 miles per hour on the interstate Limo. Not a driver, but one time my friends got a limo, and we went to Hooters since we were 12 and fascinated by breasts. At the time I was a dead ringer for Fred Savage. During the heyday of the Wonder Years. Really, I should dig up a picture, you wouldn't believe it. So, as 5 12-year-olds pull up in a limo at Hooters and basically everyone in the restaurant assumes I'm Fred Savage, we are in Las Vegas BTW. It was the best night of my preteen life. Just imagine, you are a kid, barely coming of age, and you happen into a situation with a dozen well-endowed chicks, a few on roller skirts, who fawn all over you and hand feed you chicken wings for an hour. Oh yeah, and they all have huge visible breasts that are inches from your mouth. I love my friends. None of them said a word that I wasn't famous. They, to this day, remain my four closest friends. They tell this story all the time, but it's the first time I've shared it myself. It seemed appropriate, despite the fact that the post question is something else entirely. Sorry OP. I'm 40 and I'm still fascinated by breasts. But if you frick him, I kill you. Got that? Yeah, man. I got it. Good. Oh crap. You got a white driver. What? Balam balam balam. I'm not a limo driver per se, but there was one time I remember walking through San Francisco's Union Square, and in the area are a ton of high-end hotels, the sort of places where people can afford a town car to go from point A to point B. But one day, walking past a hotel, I watched three town cars pull into the little curb cut out to pick up their calls, and then a fourth comes careening around the corner and tries to pull into the last space in the cutout. What ended up happening was something almost out of a cartoon. The fourth car hits the third parked car, which rolls into the second and thusly into the first. Driver of the car that caused all the problems steps out and surveys the damage and can only yell out, "God damn it." Every freaking time, so made me start to wonder why they kept him on. I own a limo, so basically anything goes. If I'm not driving, we draw straws to see who's the sober driver. One New Year's, myself and a few of the guys went to town. Stuck in traffic, the flatmate stands out the sunroof, points at a group of chicks and shouts, "Hey, get in the rape wagon," and they did. I'll leave the rest to your imagination. Having a few bees at home one day, we decided we needed some lemon tree since we had no lemon slices for the corona, and they double as urinals. So we took the limo down to Palmer's, plant retailer, and bought a couple of lemon trees. They were too tall to fit inside, so we had the tops of the trees sticking out of the sunroof. The looks on people's faces when a limo full of drunken Westies drives past with trees sticking out of the sunroof was priceless. We've taken it to the beach quite a few times when going to take the dogs for a walk. people looking into the open rear window of the limo expecting to see people, and it's just the dog in the back by herself being chauffeur driven like the boss she is. One night in town when I wasn't driving and had drunk far too much, I was leaning out of the sunroof to talk to someone. The lights changed. My mate floored it and I fell out. My limo has a rear facing bench seat in the middle, but no other real divider between the passenger compartment and the driver. I was driving a group of drunk very adventurous chicks around one night and one of them leaned forward to give me a thank you kiss. One of her mates got in behind her and started fingering her or something because she started moaning and fell forward so that her face was in my lap. The thank you kiss turned into a thank you BJ. There's a lot more, but those are the more interesting ones that come to mind. I am not a limo driver, per se, but one time, my friend and I had a plan to get a girl that involved me driving one. The plan was that my friend, Charlie, would ask a girl out on a date, while leading her to think that he was a super rich oil tycoon. Then, I would drive them to dinner, acting like a super courteous guy, and my buddy would say he felt sick and have to go home, leaving me and the girl alone. I needed some help with girls, cause as soon as they found out I had money, they all just wanted me for that. So, my friend, Charlie starts puking up blood everywhere, and I am all like, Charlie, what the heck? He tells me that he ate a couple of those fake blood tablets to make it seem like he was coughing blood. It actually made him sick, and he projectile vomited fake blood all over the girl. Freaking Charlie and his goddamned ideas. Whatever, we are gonna go boil some denim tomorrow. A friend of mine was a limo driver for his uncle's limo company. He said the craziest thing he ever had witness, clean up, was a bachelorette party where they dared one of the girl to down some laxatives. Her bowels let loose in the limo. It was so bad he had to stop, call his uncle for another limo to pick the women up. Meanwhile, their ambulance took crappy McGee to the nearest hospital. Cold-blooded revelations? The girls still carried on the night without the other bridesmaid. My friend had to pick her up at the hospital and take her back to her hotel, while the rest of them were at an all-male strip club. Not me, but family friend drives limos in downtown Toronto and the surrounding areas. He once had Justin Bieber going down to Stratford for his family reunion. This was maybe a year and a half ago. Justin spent the whole ride smoking joint after joint and he started having a bad trip. He kept repeating that he didn't feel good and that said family friend needs to help him because he doesn't know what's going on with him. Apparently he's a bit of a spoiltie and the reunion was filled with the biggest lot of rednecks ever. Shoulder just crashed. Taken one for the team. Whoa, so much to tell. Dropped some kids off at a 50 Cent concert, and while waiting in the limo I saw a couple of youngsters try to mug another kid. By the time I got there to pepper spray the suckers, they'd already beaten this poor kid up and taken all but his underwear. I helped him out after, called his mom to let her know and to come pick him up, and sat with him until she arrived. Man, what a crappy night. Sorry for the late post. I worked for a limo company that also ran an escort business. I would pick up Mr. Businessman at his house, grab me's escort, take him to the airport while he had a snake bite, drop him off, drop her off, and the wife and kids never knew. Not a limo driver, but I do have a story as a passenger. It was an older limo from the 80s that had a bunch of cool toggles and switches that didn't really do much, but drunken me thought it would be fun to play with all of them. Turns out after he dropped us off he went and had coffee with his wife and his limo burnt down in an electrical fire in the parking lot of McDonald's. I still feel really bad about it. I was driving a person that had sex change surgery, male to female, 3 months before her trip in my limo. She used my service about 5 nights in a row. One night she left this large dildo looking thing in the back. She called me in the middle of the night in a panic. She needed to insert that thing in her brand new vagina so it would not start to heal together like an open wound. I had to go look for the thing in the limo, then brought it back to her. 2 nights later she offered me $2,000 to have sex with her. Being broke at the time I thought long and hard about it but eventually turned her down. Never heard from her again, but she did give me a huge tip. Not a limo, but I drove a charter bus for a few bachelorette parties. For one, I picked up about 30 guys and girls. Our first stop was Beer World. We drove to downtown Pittsburgh, and they wanted to go to a bar on the south side. We pulled up to a light, and they yelled, "This is good." dude, and they piled out the emergency door, then left it open. The light turned green, so I had to drive a few blocks to find a parking spot with my rear door open, buzzer sounding, and beer bottles rolling out the open door. This was a school bus. They came back out a while later, and I took them across town to the Strip District, which was the place to go then. We were there for about 4 hours, and I napped in the bus. They all showed up right on time, even though they had to almost carry a few people. We got back to the pickup point, and they all piled out the door. The last guy says, "Thanks, dude," and gives me a hat filled with damp dollar bills. Almost $70, more than I made driving. That school bus smelled like beer for a week. Luckily, no one complained. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.